I bet they had fun.
He tried twice and didn't get tickets.
I bet it was a fun flight.
Oh, I bet.
Were your text messages going great?
Oh, lots of flights.
Okay, everybody please take a seat. We're going to call the Board of Mayor and Alderman meeting of January 13th, 2015 to order. And the first order of business is to have an invocation led by Vice Mayor Clyde Barnhill. Follow that, I'll lead the Pledge of Allegiance. Would please all stand.
Would you bow with me? Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer tonight. Thank you for the many blessings that we have. We know and recognize that we are truly a blessed nation. We give you thanks for these. We give you thanks for allowing your Son to come to this earth to be sacrificed for the remission of our sins, and that we have him as the person that we, or the individual we call upon when we come to you in prayer. We also ask your blessings on each of us as we make the decisions that ultimately affect the direction that the city of Franklin will go in. Give us spiritual wisdom and guidance. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Next item on the agenda is opportunity for citizens to make comments for items that are not on the agenda. Is there anyone who'd like to speak to this group? Please come on up. We're glad to have and welcome Mayor Travis Brown of Eagleville tonight. We had a conversation the other day, and I think this letter will be self-explanatory. You can just use that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we're glad to have you, Mayor.
I appreciate it.
All right. I appreciate you letting me come out tonight and say a few words on behalf of one of your employees. Let me just kind of read this letter here. On January 6th, the city of Eagleville responded to a fire at a business on Highway 41A. As with many fire departments in smaller cities and rural areas, the relationship between neighboring departments are critical as we provide mutual aid to one another as needed. The fire of January 6th was one such circumstance that warranted the mutual aid of several neighboring departments. What was completely unexpected was the assistance rendered by an off-duty firefighter from the Franklin Fire Department. Franklin firefighter Andy Hatford just happened to be driving by the scene, and just minutes after we got on scene, and he jumped in, and Mr. Hatford jumped to join the effort by connecting hoses and helping operate the pump truck to get the fire put out in the structure. The severity of the fire and the wind conditions were such that other neighboring buildings would have been at serious risk had the fire continued much longer. Thanks in large part to Andy Hackford, the Eagleville Fire Department was able to get the fire under control and put out before even the first backup unit for mutual aid had arrived from another area. The fire damage to the building was obviously unfortunate. As far as fire events go, the prompt response and suppression of the fire was a success. On behalf of the city of Eagleville, I would like to publicly express our appreciation for Andy Hackford for his willingness to assist his fellow firefighters. Additionally, it is worthy of note that the first unit to provide mutual aid came from Chapel Hill, Tennessee, accompanied by Chapel Hill Fire Chief Matt Stout. Eagleville firefighter Matthew Elay also responded. Both of those gentlemen also serve as firefighters for the city of Franklin. Individuals that serve in law enforcement and as firefighters in other emergency response capacities truly embody what it means to be a public servant. While we typically express our gratitude to all the agencies that respond to events like these, and we certainly do in this case, we do not want to miss this opportunity to recognize people on an individual basis for their service. The city of Eagleville is grateful for the service of Mr. Hackford, Mr. Stout, and Mr. Ely. The citizens of Franklin should be proud of the way these gentlemen represent the city of Franklin. I just want to kind of express our thanks. We really appreciate and want to honor your employees for jumping in and helping out in our time of need. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mayor Brown, thank you so much for those comments, and you're always welcome to come back in any way we can ever assist you. Please let us know. But thank you for bringing good words about our employees. We're very proud of the people that work for the city of Franklin. We're proud that they do such a great job when even they're not at work. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
So next, I met recently with Dana Meyer and Frank Auer. who were the founders or co-executive directors for a group called the Music City Strings. You've probably seen them at some of the performances at some of our events. They're a Franklin organization, even though they have Music City in their name. The unique thing is that this group was picked out of many, many musical groups across America to represent us and their body in Europe for about a 2 or 3 week tour. The purpose for them being here tonight is to highlight, number one, their excellence. Number two is to highlight that they're still trying to raise some funds to finish out the requirements for this trip. And three, for those of you that have not seen them, have quick entertainment. And I think Dana will probably make a quick comment at the end. So, please.
We are Music City Strings. We're a classically trained studio right here in Franklin, Tennessee. Tonight, though, we're going to play a couple fiddle tunes for you.
All right.
For those in the audience, it is okay to get up and dance if you feel so moved. We'll maintain decorum on the podium.
Jeez. Not Pearl.
No. I did my dance.
To see what would happen, I entered them in a competition, but never dreamed that we would actually win, which we did, and we were the youngest group. Most of the groups that were picked, it's for the Suzuki Association of America's International Conference in Minnesota. They picked two performing groups from all of North and South America, and it's usually groups that are 30 years old and mostly high school students. So we're the youngest group ever to be picked, and the only group from the South. And so, you know, so we went there and it was amazing. They did a great job performing. And then League of Astonishing Strings heard us. And so they approached me and said, you know, we've never had a group this young, but how would you feel about doing a concert tour of Europe in Barcelona, Spain, Paris, London, and Scotland? And so, you know, of course I was but a little scared, but I thought, yeah, we can do this. So this is about half of our group. And they, what I love about, they're a Canadian group up in the League of Astonishing Strings, and they've been managing string groups and having kids come over and perform for 20 years. And they said specifically that they wanted us to represent Tennessee and the music of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. So that's what we've been working on. And if any of you want to support us, you can go to our website, and it's musiccitystrings.org, and we have PayPal. There's a place to donate, and an address too if you wanted to send something in. But I really think this city should know about what a gem it has that's only 10 years old, and you know, these kids and these families from this community are really amazing. So we're going to finish now with a piece that's everyone's favorite. One, two.
Good way to start off the new year, don't you think? With Rocky Excellent. Top and Tennessee Waltz. So next we'll move to approval of the minutes. Alderman Peterson, I think you indicated you had some corrections. So I'd look for a motion for approval.
For approval with a couple of changes. And Mayor, I realized I couldn't pull up the minutes in front of me. But in one of on page two, on the work session, I want to take not out of the thing, my comment, because it says exactly the opposite of what I said. On the other part, it's on page four, and it's where Shauna McCoy is talking, and I'm sorry, I don't have, as I say, I don't have the thing that I sent, or I don't have a copy of the of this here. If I may, like to add a sentence on that. I apologize for not.
We want to just take that up next time.
If you don't mind. Thank you very much.
I think that'd be better.
I had sent them, but I wasn't aware that.
Are there any recognitions tonight? Any miscellaneous reports?
Mr. Mayor, I do want to recognize Deputy Chief Chris Gentry is with us tonight.
I see that.
For the first time in a long time. Chris has been on a deployment for 2 years in South Korea. Chris serves as a Brigadier General, and we're feel blessed to have him back and thank him for his service abroad, but in Franklin as well.
Very good report. We'll now consider the consent agenda, items number 8 through 20. 24 are on the consent agenda and are considered to be non-controversial and routine in nature. I would consider a motion, but remind you that item number 10 needs to be pulled.
We'll defer that to the
motion 10. To approve consent agenda with item number 10 being deferred.
Second.
Do you want to put a deferred date and we won't have to vote on that?
Do we want to do it in 2 weeks?
February 10th.
February the 10th.
Mm-hmm.
Appropriate second. Motion. Seconded by Alderman Bransford. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes unanimously. Item number one now, consideration ordinance 2014-21 to be entitled an ordinance to rezone 6.19 acres from general commercial to specific development residential SDR 58.8 for the property located at 427 Nickel Mill Lane. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Appropriate motion by Alderman Bransford, seconded by Alderman Blanton. Any discussion?
I do not feel that I can support this because of the density and also because of the very small lot, which is going to make things like stormwater very difficult to work with.
Any other discussion? Ready to vote? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Passes 7-1. We'll move on to item number two, consideration ordinance 2014-39, an ordinance to amend the fiscal year 2014-15 budget, establishing a public hearing for January 27, 2015. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Appropriate motion, seconded by Vice Mayor Barnhill. Motion made by Alderman Peterson. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes unanimously. Number three, consideration resolution 2014-77, a resolution to approve the letter of intent with GE Water and Process Technologies for the purchase of the hollow fiber membrane filtration system equipment for the Franklin Water Treatment Plant and authorize the city engineer to execute the final purchase contract and revise final equipment purchase without seeking approval from the Board of Mayor and Aldermen. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Second.
Appropriate motion made by Alderman Blanton, seconded by Alderman Berger. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes unanimously. Mr. Stuckey, clarification on number four.
This is when we do need to defer to next meeting.
We do need to defer it. So this is consideration of contract to award to Life Science. I would ask for deferral until the January 27th meeting.
So moved.
Second.
Appropriate motion second. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes unanimously. Next would be item number five, consideration resolution 2015-03, a resolution of the Board of Mayor and Aldermen of the City of Franklin to express support for the maintenance of current troop levels at Fort Campbell and to urge Congress to oppose any reductions.
Move for approval.
Second.
Appropriate motion by Alderman Bransford and seconded by Alderman Berger. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes unanimously. Item number six is acknowledge the report of emergency purchase of products and services to establish a replacement temporary fire station number 7 for the fire department.
Move for approval.
Second.
Mr. Mayor, I'd ask that you specifically read in the resolution because we have changed this action a little bit from what was on the original agenda to the resolution granting authority to the city administrator to take various actions to implement the project.
This would be resolution number 2015-07, a resolution authorizing the city administrator to execute the various aspects of the temporary fire station number 7 project within a project budget of $150,000. Is that adequate?
Yes, that's great.
Okay. Do we have a motion?
I second it. Somebody.
Yeah, there's a.
Let's see. Help me remember who made the motion.
Mike and Mike. Myself second.
Okay, got that. Okay. Alderman McClendon.
I'm sure many of us received a number of emails. I'm thankful to the citizens that take the time to express themselves. I am particularly thankful to the citizens who took the time to express themselves in their own words.
Any other comments, any discussion? Alderman Skinner?
This could be very similar to a petition, so I think it's just as valid. That's all.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, passes unanimously. Item number seven is a reappointment of Jen Porter Ross to the Franklin Housing Authority.
Move for approval.
Appropriate motion is seconded by Alderman Martin. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, passes unanimously. We've already taken care of item number 10 with the Vice Mayor's motion, so I think we can have a motion to adjourn.
So moved. Second. I'm good at that.
Motion second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oh.
Well, now I know something.